Now, solution to engineering mechanics, one more problem. Very, very simple. Let me proceed. Problem set 2.3 of engineering mechanics, Tata McGraw-Hill by Timoshenko, Young, Rao and Sukumar Pathy. Solution to 2.23. A ball whose weight is Q is equal to 53.4 newton, it rests in a right angled draw. Look at this, is a draw. Right angle means the angle ABC is 90 degree. The ball is resting on that, and the ball is touching this side at point D and this side at point E. The weight is vertically downward Q. As shown in figure B, determine the forces exerted on the sides of the trough at D and E if all surfaces are perfectly smooth. The moment I say perfectly smooth, there is no frictional force present, and frictional force F is given as the coefficient of friction times the normal reaction. This is not there. So, RD is the normal reaction at point D. At point D, the reaction force to this side passing through the point O. RE is the normal reaction at point T. The reaction provided by this surface to the ball at point T is pointing this side. So what is the conclusion? RD and RE originate at point D and E respectively. RD originates at point D, RE originates at point E, and pass towards the ball. This reaction force passes towards the ball. This reaction force passes towards the ball, and both pass through this point called the center O. Now, I have redrawn the diagram for you once again. Now, this green line is the right angle trough angle at B. This angle is 90, it is given. Now, this angle is 30 given, this angle is 60 as given. This is the center O. From point D, the reaction force RD is passing through O, directed this way. From point E, the reaction force RE is passing through the point O, directed to this side. Now, how? We have to find out how this angle is 60 and how this angle is 30. Now look at, let this point is F, this point is G. And this is D and this is E, this point is B. Now, very simple, in triangle FGB, this angle is 30, this is 90. So, angle, if this is given, this is 90, this is 30 given. So, angle BFG will be 60 degree, and therefore angle DFO, which is vertically opposite to this angle, will also be 60 degree. Now, so angle DFO is 60. Therefore, angle DOF in triangle DOF will be 30 degree in this triangle, because the sum of the three angles is 90 degree. So this we have found out 30. Now, therefore, the vertically opposite to this is this angle. So this will also be 30. Now, at point O, this black dotted line and this black dotted line make 90 degree. This angle is 60. Therefore, we are left with 60. So this is 60. And this angle, is vertically opposite to this. So this will be also 60. This will also be 60. So I have again now the free body diagram at the point O for the three forces Q, reaction force at E and reaction force at D in the second diagram, in the third diagram. So taking O as the origin, I have drawn the axis. This point is O, this is your X, this is your X dash, this is your Y, this is your Y dash, Q is vertically downward. This angle I explained as 30, this angle I explained as 60. So therefore this is 30 because from here to here will be 90. 30, therefore this is 60, this is 90, this is 90. So this angle from here to here will be 60 plus 30, that is 90. From here to here will be 90 plus 30, that is 120. From here to here, this way, will be 90 plus 60, that is equal to 150. So now apply Lemmy's theorem. So Q over sine of 60 plus 30, sine 90, is equal to Re over 60 plus 90 sine 150 is equal to Rd over sine 90 plus 30, that is sine 120. Now rest is very simple. Now if you take these two and cross multiply, you get Re. If you take these two and cross multiply, you get Rd. So very simple. So by doing so, we get Re is equal to sine 150 over sine 90 is Q. Q value of Q is given. Take sine 90 is 1. Put the value of sine 50 at value of Q, you get 26.7 Newton. Similarly, Rd is sine 20 over sine 90 into Q. Put the value of Q, sine 90 is 1. Put the value of sine 120, it comes out to be 46.24 Newton. As simple as that.